तो कैन वी स्टार्ट? तो
सर
इन प्रीवियस क्लास एक्चुअली आई गेव यू द फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ पोटेंशियल एंड आई टोल्ड यू दैट पोटेंशियल इटसेल्फ हैज लिटिल मीनिंग बट पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस कैरीज ऑन ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन बिकॉज इट इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू वर्क and hence associated with energy also, right? So, potential difference is the quantity which is very, very important. And I told you that if you want to calculate VAB, that means from when you are going from B to A, from point B to A, you are moving, then this is equal to minus integral some initial point to final point and E dot dr or dl, whatever you want to write, E dot dr or dl. I think I have written dl first of all. So let me write dl. This I told you, right? So this happened to be equal to VA minus VB. That is the potential difference between two points. Correct?
Yes, sir. So
up to this, I hope that total concept was clear. But we will have to revisit it. One thing I would like to talk about is the potential alone. Many times you see that the potential at this point is this much. We have seen that. For example, I would like to take the case of a point charge. A very simple case of a point charge in which what will happen? Suppose the charge is Q, right? And at some point, say A and B are the points like this. And from B, you want to come to A with a charge, say capital Q or something like this, that. So you want to bring this capital Q charge from B to A. So because both charge are say positive, then you will have to do some work. That concept I already gave you. And based on that, actually, I derived the concept of potential. So that was essentially derived from that. So what is what is the potential difference between these points? And we will understand many things associated with it. And then I will generalize the concept to complicated potential. So this is a case in which a simple potential will come. And we can understand many, many things using the simple potential, right? So using the simple potential, we will understand many things. So what is the potential between this VAB? I want to know. So VAB, I mean potential difference between A and B will be given by minus integral. So let me call this distance as RA. And this distance as RB, right? So it will be integral KQ by R square, that is the electric field, and dot dr, right? So the dot product will give you one because the direction both are radial, correct? So both are radial, so they will give you one. So that this is one by KQ by R square dot dr. Okay. So what will be this integral from some point, say you are coming from RB to RA, right? So tell me what you are going to get.
So KQ by RA minus KQ by RB.
You will get first of all KQ and you will get 1 by R, right?
Yes, sir.
Is that okay?
Lower limit, sir, RV plus RN.
Lower limit?
RV plus RN.
No, these are position vectors actually. Yahan pe maine thoda sa galat likh diya. These are the position vectors. Suppose this is a reference point and these are the position vectors RA and the position vector RB. It is like this. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So, what we will get here, it will be RA, it will be RB. So, what you are going to get?
So, 1 by RA minus 1 by RB.
So, it will be 1 by KQ, 1 by RA minus 1 by RB. Is this okay?
Yes, sir.
This is okay. So now, which one is greater? Your R of B is greater than R of A?
Yes, sir.
This is greater. So you can see that VA minus VB is positive. Right?
Yes, sir.
Potential at A is greater than potential at B. So that's why you have to do work. Please understand this. Potential at A is greater than potential at B. So that's why it is needed an external work. If it would have been vice versa, so obviously the charge will go automatically. So it is like taking water from level 1 to level 2. So if level 2 has higher potential, you will have to do some work. And if you want to take this water to the lower potential, you gravitational field will do the work. Here electric field will do the work. Okay. So this is positive. So understand it in terms of numbers. Now, if I take this reference point B, so now I am telling you how we write potentials sometimes at a point. Actually, it can't be written. In general, it can't be written. But I told you in previous class that we take references in many cases. We take references and using those references, we write a potential at a point. So if I take this B to infinity, this point B to infinity as a reference. So for a point charge, infinity reference works very well. Okay. So you take B at infinity, what will happen? VA minus V infinity will become what?
KQ by RA.
KQ. By RA. So you now don't need any suffix because you know only one suffix will be left, right? So you don't need two suffixes. So it will become KQ by R. And V infinity as a reference, we take equal to zero because if you put RB is equal to infinity, that will become zero. So that's how we write the potential at a given point is equal to KQ by R. Please see this. Is this okay?
Yes, sir.
So now a very important concept comes that if I have a potential like this at a point and the reference potential is at zero. So in this case, what we have done is the reference potential is equal to zero. The reference potential has goes to infinity and it is equal to zero. Not in every case, the reference potential at infinity will become zero. Can anybody give an example?
Infinite rod?
It will not happen always. So for example, if you take infinite charge, for example, infinite rod, the length is infinite. So you will go far and far, but still the potential will not go to zero. So the reference potential in that case at infinity will not become zero. Okay. But in this particular case, it is happening. So now I want to tell you a very important concept.
Sir, ye dobara repeat karo sir, jo abhi aapne repeat kiya hai sir.
Okay. Main ye keh raha tha ki jaise point charge ke liye तुमने यहां पोटेंशियल लिखा ओके वी, और जब तुमने इंफिनिटी पे पोटेंशियल लिखा तो वो जीरो हो गया, राइट?
यस सर, यस सर.
सो यू कैन टेक रेफरेंस पोटेंशियल एट इंफिनिटी एंड इन टर्म्स ऑफ दैट यू कैन टेल ऑलवेज व्हाट इज द पोटेंशियल. सो व्हेन यू आर सेइंग द पोटेंशियल एट दिस पॉइंट, सो दैट मींस यू आर सेइंग दैट रेफरेंस पोटेंशियल एट इंफिनिटी इज जीरो. ओके,
यस सर, यस सर.
बिकॉज अगर मैं तुमसे कहूं किसी चीज की लेंथ इतनी है,
यस सर,
अमिताभ बच्चन की वो मूवी देखिए ना, इतना बड़ा, जब तक आपका रेफरेंस पॉइंट नहीं आता तब तक नोबडी कैन अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, राइट?
यस सर.
व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट रेफरेंस अल्टीट्यूड्स, द रेफरेंस लेवल इज ऑलवेज द सी लेवल. When you say this much of altitude, so everybody knows you are talking with respect to sea level.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So,
yes, sir.
Potential also, you have to, you know, you have to have a reference point. Na? Without the reference point, nobody would be able to understand what potential you are talking about. So, if the reference point is infinity, then the potential due to this charge is this V. And that will be given by V is equal to KQ by R. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is that okay?
Sir, वो जो आपने example दिया था कि infinity पे हमेशा जो है
ये point charge है, इसकी वजह से potential लगातार कम होता जा रहा है, and at infinity it will become zero.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you take infinite length rod. And charge is spread on it, right?
Yes, sir.
So you may go very, very far. Then this rod will also become very, very long. And this charge will be giving a potential at this point, right? So the distance, because of this distance, the potential will decrease. But that charge will play a role to overcome that potential, and we will calculate it after two or three classes, the potential due to such a system, right?
Yes, sir.
So in this case, we will have to settle with a reference point that we will choose. हमें खुद reference point लेना पड़ेगा, और फिर हम उसके respect में किसी point S पे potential बता सकते हैं. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is very, very important. So I have told you. In many cases, when the electromagnetic waves are traveling, for example, thousands of distances from India to America, you have to choose the reference potential as the curvature of the Earth. Then you have to select the potential, the reference potential as the curvature of the Earth and the sea. Okay, so you have to consider that. In some cases, we consider Earth as a reference potential. We say na that potential of Earth is zero. Okay,
yes, sir.
So because that is zero is better na. You'd want to take a reference potential, take it equal to zero. And I will give you a very good example of a battery. So in battery, you call this potential as 12 volt with reference to infinity, and this as zero. Right? So if this is at potential 12 volt with respect to infinity, and this is at potential 0 volt with respect to infinity. For practical purpose, you can take this as a reference potential, right? So call this as 0 and this as 12 volt. Reference is gone because you have two points, na? When two points are there, you will just calculate the potential difference because that is associated with work. So this is 12 volt, this is 0 volt. And अगर ये suppose this is minus 6 and this is 6, so it is better to represent it like this, na? Because
yes,
potential difference is still zero. So that's why we take this potential reference potential equal to zero and this as 12. Is that okay?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So now potential difference is the quantity which is very, very important, and you are already using it. I have told you, in your inverter batteries, in your chargers, everywhere potential is there, and potential difference between the two terminals is there. So when you say 12 volt, it is potential difference between the two terminals. Is that okay? Now, I was talking about a charge and its potential, and you told me that it is a quantity which is associated with R, right?
Yes, sir.
And it will be, is it direction dependent?
No, sir.
It is a scalar quantity. And so what will happen that at any point around it, at same distance R, you will get a surface at which potential is same, and this surface is known as equipotential surface. This is known as equipotential surface, right? Now, if you take any distance, for example, this was some distance. If you take this distance, this will be the equipotential surface. If you take this distance, this will be the equipotential surface. So potential, suppose here it is V1, here it will be V2, here it will be V3. So all of the surface will have same potential. So for a point charge, this is the equipotential surface that you can draw. Right?
Yes, sir.
So what is this? Geometrically, ye kya hai?
Sphere.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Bhai, you are at some point. Aap charo taraf dekhte ho, agar same distance pe points le lo, to potential same aa jayega. Because
yes,
it is only
yes,
depending
sir.
On R. So that will, what will be the locus of that? Sabka collection kya hoga? It will be sphere?
Yes, sir.
And yes, let us see how it is sphere. Please see. You have V is equal to K Q by R, which is X square plus Y square plus Z square.
Yeah, sir.
Under root. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, once you're taking a particular distance, this potential is constant?
Yes, sir.
So this whole quantity becomes X square plus Y square plus Z square is equal to KQ by V naught.
Yeah.
Tell me.
Yes, sir. The whole square, sir.
Wait. So this is root. And
root.
This will be KQ by V naught, and then it will be whole square.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
So now this is equation of a sphere with the radius KQ by V naught. So radius of a sphere is not always meter. In statistical mechanics, sometimes it will be momentum. In quantum mechanics, it may be sometimes energy. And here it is some KQ by V naught. Okay. So X square plus Y square plus Z square is equal to, so the locus of those points is some R square, where R is equal to KQ by V naught. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So now when this is a constant, R is a constant, so you will get one sphere, you change R, you will get another. How you will change R? You will change the potential.
Yes,
you
sir.
Will change the distance.
Yes, sir.
So that's why you will change the potential, the value of the potential. The value of the potential will be same on the whole surface. So please see, this is the equation of sphere. So the locus of those points will give you equipotential surface. And I want to tell you more. I want to tell you that what is happening with V1, V2, V3, tell me, increasing and decreasing order.
So V3 is less than V2, is less than V1.
So V1 is greater?
Yes, sir.
V2 and V3? So this is the direction in which potential is increasing. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
This is from this surface. If you jump to this surface, so suppose this is 50 volt. So this is 30 volt and this is 20 volt. Something like that. Don't go on numbers. Kuch aisa hoga ya nahin hoga? The potential will be continuously decreasing. When you are, once you are, so your electric field, that will be in the direction of opposite to this increasing potential. Perpendicular to the equipotential surface and just opposite will be the direction of electric field. So this is the nature of electric field which we are discussing. Our electric field, I told you, once we calculated the work, it was independent on the paths. Path independent tha ya nahi tha?
Yes,
it
yes,
was
sir.
Path independent, and the electric field was actually conservative in nature. It is not a general vector function. It is very specific. Later on, I will tell you that curl of this will be zero in the electric electrostatic case. That will come little later. But till now, please understand this. कि जिन surfaces पे potential लगातार, अब देखो potential
उल्टा हो,
एक सेकंड मैंने उल्टा लिख दिया, this numbers उल्टा हो गया ना, because you are going far, so what will happen, this will be 50, this will be 30 and this will be 20, right?
Yes sir.
So the potential is actually decreasing by distance increase ho raha hai na, so potential will be decreasing, so potential is increasing in this direction and electric field is opposite to it. So you can write electric field is off your mic, kisi ke mic se awaaz aa rahi hai, electric field किस डायरेक्शन में होगी
सर, अपोजिट टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग पोटेंशियल,
इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल बी अपोजिट इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग पोटेंशियल, राइट दिस पॉइंट, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, यस
सर, अगर चार्ज नेगेटिव हो
तो चीजें उसी तरीके से बदल जाएंगी, जब मैं जो कह रहा हूँ बात सेम होगी, जैसे मान लो चार्ज नेगेटिव हो तो उसी हिसाब से सारे पोटेंशियल्स नेगेटिव हो जाएंगे, राइट?
यस।
और नेगेटिव में तुम्हें पता है कि अगर मैग्नीट्यूड बढ़ेगा इसका मतलब ओवरऑल चीज कम होगी, सो इट विल बी लाइक दैट, ओके
ओके सर,
सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड will be opposite in the direction of increasing potential and it will be perpendicular to the equipotential surface. Second point, it will be perpendicular to equipotential surface. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me from here the concept of like charges repel each other and unlike charges attract each other is also coming? Because if this is the charge and you want to bring this charge towards it, then you will have to do some work. That means it is continuously repelling. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Earth ke case mein opposite ho jata hai. बिकॉज मास जो होता है वो अट्रैक्ट करता है, तो इसलिए मास से अपोजिट जाने में वर्क करना पड़ता है, मास की तरफ जाने में वर्क नहीं करना पड़ता. इज दैट कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर ना, दोनों तरीके से?
यस सर.
सो दिस इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इक्विपोटेंशियल सरफेस. ओके, अभी आज एक बहुत ही आई विल डिस्कस विद यू दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. So this was so simple to draw the equipotential surface in this case. And let me finish the formulation and then I will come to the questions. And the final formulation will end to the concept of gradient. So now dekhte hain ki gradient ka concept kaise aata hai. Theek hai na? Let us see how this concept of gradient comes. So we know that this V is equal to the concept of gradient. So what we know is that V is equal to what? Iska mic on hai bhai.
So forget it.
Okay. So what is the potential equal to? The formula that I have told you,
KQ by R.
it is minus integral E dot dl?
Yes, sir.
Yes? This is the formula of potential?
Yes, sir.
And if I want to write just a small potential, I will write it equal to what I will write? It will be minus E, dhyan se dekhna, and delta L. Yes or no? Just no need to integrate. Just I want to go a small step. For example, let me give you an example also. Suppose you want to go from this B to A and field is in this direction. And I want to move from here to here. So what I will do? So this is the dl, delta L, right? And you will take the component of electric field in this direction. Yes or no? Because electric field is in this. So you will take the dot product of this. So that's why this dot product is coming. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So the small potential will be delta V is equal to minus E dot delta L. And you open it, it will become delta V is equal to minus E delta L cos of theta. Up to this, everything is okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, delta V by delta L is equal to, this is it. Delta V by delta L is equal to minus E into cos theta?
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
अब देखना ये शायद आपने कभी ध्यान से ना देखा हो इस चीज को जो अभी निकल के आने वाली है मैथमेटिक्स बिकॉज यू नो ग्रेडियंट क्या होता है यू स्टार्ट डूइंग द क्वेश्चंस बट किसी का अभी भी माइक ऑन है किसका ऑन है
तो सूर्य वर्मा इनका बार बार ऑन हो जाता है
सूर्य
सर
भाई ऑफ करके
रखो ओके सर
ओके सो ये देखना जरा बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग बात है कि डेल्टा वी बाय डेल्टा एल इज माइनस ई कॉस थीटा राइट
यस सर
यस सर
अब मैं चाहता हूं ये देखना कि मेरा पोटेंशियल किस डायरेक्शन में मैक्सिमम चेंज हो रहा है इस बात को ध्यान से सुनो आई वांट टू सी द चेंज इन पोटेंशियल व्हिच इज मैक्सिमम सो व्हाट आई विल डू आई विल राइट डेल्टा वी बाय डेल्टा एल इज इक्वल टू मैक्सिमम is equal to E.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And by taking cos of theta is equal to minus 1?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
That means theta is equal to pi?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
तो अगर मैं उस डायरेक्शन में चलूं जिधर पोटेंशियल सबसे तेजी से बदल रहा है सबसे तेजी से बढ़ रहा है तो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड उसके पाई तरफ होगी यानी जस्ट अपोजिट होगी सो दिस इज व्हाट आई हैव टोल्ड यू यूजिंग द इक्विपोटेंशियल सरफेस आल्सो सो कैन यू सी दिस सो डेल्टा वी बाय डेल्टा एल दैट केम आउट टू बी ई सो इफ दिस इज मैक्सिमम सो प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दिस स्मॉल कैलकुलेशन इज वेरी वेरी ब्यूटिफुल एंड राइट फ्यू लाइन्स अबाउट इट So this tells a lot about the relation between E and V. What is the first one? The magnitude of electric field is given by the rate of change of potential. Right? What is the magnitude of electric field? Please write. The magnitude of electric field intensity is given by?
Rate of change of potential.
Maximum rate of change of potential. Magnitude of electric field is given by maximum rate of change of potential and the field is obtained. Please write the second point about the theta here. Write the second point. This maximum value is obtained. ये maximum कब आ रही है? देखो cos theta की तो बहुत सारी values है ना?
Theta unit.
भाई cos theta की value कहाँ से कहाँ तक है? बताओ minus one से plus one तक है, right? So it will be minus one, minus 0.9, minus 0.7, then zero, then one, then 0.7. So when you are getting the maximum value, when you are moving, hello?
Yes, sir.
Just at pi angle. Opposite. So please write this. The second point, the maximum value is obtained when the direction of the distance increment is opposite to the field. डिस्टेंस इंक्रीमेंट जिस डायरेक्शन में हो रहा है इज अपोजिट टू द फील्ड. यस और नो?
यस सर.
सो इन द डायरेक्शन इन विच पोटेंशियल इज इंक्रीजिंग मोस्ट रैपिडली इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज अपोजिट टू दैट. रिवाइज दिस. In the direction in which potential is increasing more rapidly, the electric field is opposite to it. Do you agree with this or not?
Yes, sir.
So if you have, potentials like this, this is potential zero, this is potential 100 volt, and these are the surfaces at which the potential is constant. What will be the direction of field? Tell me.
100 volt to 0 volt.
So it will be, this is the direction in which the potential is increasing most rapidly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And this will be the direction of the electric field. Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we have come to a point where we know this, that the electric field is actually, so what we know is that the electric field is opposite to it, right? So I will write a formula now. Please see this. This is the direction of change of V. So electric field will be, if I claim that this is the n cap in which potential is changing, potential is increasing most rapidly. What is the direction n cap? In which the potential is increasing most rapidly, then electric field will be given by minus dv by d. I mean, I am calling this not x, I am taking n, so it will be some n into n cap. This is the definition of electric field. So this operation on V, अभी ये मैंने बहुत first class में बताया था और वापस उस पे आ रहा हूं. Suppose you have a vector R and that is x I cap plus y j cap plus z j cap, right? So if you want to know what is the unit vector in this direction, what you will do? You will do this, del x, del R by del x. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Then
yes,
you will get I cap. This you remember for an n-dimensional vector I told you?
Yes, sir.
If you want in this direction, you will differentiate it with respect to y. So if you want in n direction, you will differentiate it with respect to n. Yes or no? The yes, same sir. Logic I am using. So the operation which is happening on the potential to get the field is known as gradient. Right? So what is the gradient? The operation on V to get E. इसी मैथमेटिकल लॉजिक को हम क्या कह देते हैं? वी कॉल इट अ ग्रेडियंट. वी कॉल दिस अ ग्रेडियंट. सो दैट मींस ई विल बी इक्वल टू, व्हाट विल बी इक्वल टू? माइनस ऑफ, दिस ऑपरेशन इज नोन एज ग्रेड ग्रेडियंट एंड वी. करेक्ट?
यस सर.
सो इफ यू यूज लिटिल बिट ऑफ कैलकुलस, then I want to show you once in a life, you should see that from where these things are coming. बाद में याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, but एक बार अगर आपको origin पता होता है, तो that is actually very, very beautiful. Okay? So ये बात सारी समझ में आ गई?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, let us write let us write this in the form of calculus, the potential in two ways. So how we can write the dV, small potential? Tell me, you all know. Del V by
del x into dx.
dx plus
del V upon
by del y
dy
plus del V by del z dz. This is how we write the potential?
Yes, sir.
And by the definition, how I can write small potential dV? V is E dot dl. So how we can write? Minus E dot dl.
Yes, sir.
So this will be dV is equal to minus, take the dot product.
E dot dx.
It will be minus ex dx plus ey dy plus ez dz, correct? Because the electric field in general will be written as ex I cap plus ey j cap plus ez k cap. Yes or no? And what is dl in general? It will be dx I cap plus dy j cap plus dz k cap. Correct? This much we have been using many, many times. Yes or no? So when you take the dot product, you will get this. Up to this, any confusion, any problem? No?
Clear, sir.
Clear? अब देखो जरा इसको हटा देता हूँ, ये तो आपको पता ही है। अब जरा दोनों तरफ कंपेयर करो, dv dv both sides, dx dx both sides. So can we compare? Ex will be what? Minus del v by del x. Ey will be what? Minus del v by del y. And ez will be what? Minus del v by del z. So components we have got, and what is the electric field? Abhi likha tha. Again, I would like to write it. What is the electric field? It is x component, I cap, y component, j cap, and z component, k cap. This is the electric field?
Yes, sir.
Now put it there. What you will get? E is equal to minus. So you will get I cap del by del x plus j cap del by del y plus k cap del by del z and v. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now I told you that electric field is equal to minus the operation times v, and this operation is grad, and this is represented like this, and it came out to be del by del x plus j del by del y plus k del by del z. So puri story samajh aayi? So finally, we got for electrostatic field, the electric field can be written as minus del. So see, such a beautiful thing. And this is vector and this is vector, right? And this is a scalar. So the information is stored in the form of a scalar function, and you can get the electric field from that using this gradient operator. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So now I want to do a problem. अभी तक इसमें कोई दिक्कत हो तो बताओ. If you have any problem in understanding or anything.
Any problem? Sir.
Okay, clear?
Yes,
so
sir.
Now you understood what is the origin, and this is only for electrostatic field. Please remember, there is no, the charge is stationary. So only the field will come from this scalar potential. And when the charge will start moving, you will have another term that will come later on. So this, right now, there is no other term. E is equal to minus del V. Plus, please remember, कि इसको मैं आगे जाके मॉडिफाई करूंगा व्हेन द चार्ज विल स्टार्ट मूविंग एंड यू विल हैव द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड आल्सो. ओके सो देन दिस विल बी मॉडिफाइड यूजिंग अ वेक्टर पोटेंशियल. वो बाद में आएगा, अभी उसकी कोई जरूरत नहीं है. सो प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, ये जो डेल है जो आपने रेक्टेंगुलर के लिए लिखा है, this will be modified for cylindrical, modified for spherical polar, nothing else. Everything else will remain same, the formulation will remain same. So I want to show you a very nice thing using a very simple question. मान लो आपसे कोई कहे, मैं एक पोटेंशियल का एग्जाम्पल ले लेता हूं. Let me take an example. The potential. Potential is also written by phi, written by V. Okay? So don't get confused. और किसी एक notation में फंसना नहीं है, because examiner तो कोई भी notation use कर सकता है. So for example, unit vector I cap is also used, X cap is also used, right? And some people use AX. तो आप कुछ कर नहीं सकते ना. Whatever is given to you, you have to use that. So this vector is also used as unit vector. So we should understand the concept, not go with the notations. Okay? So phi is given as A x square minus y square. This is some potential, right? The potential is given. And I want electric field from this potential. Okay? I want to calculate electric field using this potential. So this is a scalar function. I want electric field, and you know electrostatic field is given by minus del V, del phi here, okay? And these, if you want, you can put vector, otherwise you can understand ye vector quantity hai, toh obviously ye bhi vector hai, because ye toh scalar hai, right? Okay?
Yes, sir.
So operate karo. So it will be minus I cap del by del X plus J cap del by del Y plus k cap del by del z, okay, and into a times x square minus y square. So what answer you will get for electric field? So it will be minus, tell me,
minus 2x I cap
minus 2ax I cap
plus 2ay j cap
plus 2ay J cap, and that component will. So this is the electric field. Electric field is a vector quantity. This has come. So this information was stored in the form of potential, and now you got the field. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now I want to show you same thing for this potential. अभी तो आपने एक बहुत ही simple सा potential लिया था. That was also not very simple. आपने point charge की वजह से potential लिया था. What was that? One upon x, okay, k to constant here, 1 upon x square plus y square plus z square under root, right? That was the potential. Yes. Now this time a different type. Don't forget, you have seen such a potential, phi is equal to a upon root x square plus y square plus z square. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So if somebody asks you, what is the source of this potential? You should say point charge. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you have a potential like this. And I want to understand what is happening to equipotential surface right now. Okay. So let us take this constant as positive. And let us see what is happening to this. So same method mein draw karne ki koshish karte hain. Okay. Using the equipotential surface. So what will happen? This x square minus y square will become some phi by a. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Everybody, are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
The same way, yes, I draw the spheres, they were the equipotential surface. Now I will take this quantity as some constants. So let us take this as, kya le lo batao? Alpha le lo. This alpha. And I will take this different potentials and I will get different locus of the points. So let us start. So first point main leta hun, suppose I take this alpha as some constant I have to take, and let me take it equal to zero. Okay? Zero potential. So what will happen? The y square will become x square, and you will get y is equal to, say, minus x, and y is equal to plus x. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this will be our xy plane, and this this is corresponding to potential is equal to zero. Okay, for simplicity, let me take a is equal to one, so that this will only become five, just for simplicity. Otherwise you can keep it, no problem. This will become five. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
So this is the first set of. Now, as a second case, I will take x square minus y square is equal to 1. Okay? So just to tell you about the equipotential surface, this is equal to 1. So what? Now, you will have to write y square is equal to 1 minus x square. Right?
So x square minus 1.
X square minus 1?
Yes, sir.
Y square will be equal to x square minus 1. And if I take this is equal to 2, then?
X square minus 2.
So y square will be equal to x square minus 2. So like that, we will start getting different type of curves. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you want to see what type of surfaces it will make, for example, at x is equal to 0, you can't go beyond 1. So obviously you can't go beyond this, because imaginary numbers will come, that will go on the another surface. So at you will get the curves like this. See, so you will start from here and you will get something like this.
Hyperbola curves.
Yeah. Like this. Okay. And similarly, on this side, you will get the curves like this. And this, these all are equipotential surfaces. So this is corresponding to phi is equal to 0. This line is corresponding to phi is equal to 0. Then phi is equal to 1, phi is equal to 2, like that. You will start getting. Okay?
Yes, sir.
And you can take negative values of potentials also. So, for example, x square minus y square is equal to minus 1. And x square minus y square is equal to minus 2, the different values of potential.
Yes, sir.
So what you are going to get is like this. So these are the equipotential surfaces. Are you able to see?
Parabola, sir.
Okay. So starting from the straight lines, and then the equation of this y square is equal to x square minus y square is equal to 1. So all such equations can be plotted and seen. So aap wo cheez feel kar rahe ho ki ye sare surface jo hai wo equipotential surface hai. Kehne ka matlab ye hai, isme aap chalte chale jao kahin bhi, potential ki value kya rahegi? 1.
Yes, sir.
इसमें कहीं भी चलते चले जाओ, पोटेंशियल की वैल्यू क्या रहेगी? 2. आर यू गेटिंग इट? सो दीज आर द, अब रिमेंबर व्हाट आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट इक्विपोटेंशियल सरफेस. पोटेंशियल की वैल्यू बढ़ रही है इधर. हेलो,
यस सर.
दिस इज द डायरेक्शन वेयर पोटेंशियल इज इंक्रीजिंग. सो दिस विल बी द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. because this is the direction where potential is increasing, electric field will be just opposite to the direction of it. Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
So the same pattern can be seen. So you can draw the field lines in this way. So you can draw the field lines like this. And along this, the field will be in this direction. At this y is equal to zero. It will be in this direction. And abhi side pe kya hoga? You can guess now.
Sir, symmetric.
Coming like this?
Yes, sir.
Again, the same rules will be followed, right?
Yes, sir.
And what will happen on this side?
Downward.
On this side, it will be going like this. It will be going like this. And what will happen to this side? It will be going like this. It will be going like this. So please see, the same concept is followed everywhere. So when the value of y is positive, the field at zero here will be in this direction, and in this direction, when you come the downside, this will be in this direction. So you are just moving perpendicular to the equipotential surface here also. And in previous case, it was little easy, na? When the circular, when the spherical thing was there, so it was easy to move in that direction. Ye dekho zara samjho aur koi doubt ho to batao. So I want to show you, if you wish to, just give me a second. Aap thoda sa please see this. Please see the equipotential surfaces. So the first one, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Haan, sir, visible, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, sabse pehle dekho, x square minus y square is equal to zero le liya.
Yes, sir.
And you got these straight lines. Can you see them? Set of straight lines?
Yes, sir.
Uske baad tumne one le liya, to blue wala dikh raha hai. Ye kaun sa color hai? Second wala? Blue?
Yes, sir.
So, can you see the set? This side? Phir isko two le liya. Then the green one?
Yes, sir.
Phir uske baad next one, three le liya. Okay? फिर नेगेटिव ले लिया तो ऊपर आने शुरू हो गए. नेगेटिव वन देखो, ब्लैक वाला ऊपर.
यस सर.
सो ऑल दीज सरफेसेस आर इक्विपोटेंशियल सरफेस एंड यू कैन सी दैट यू हैव. यहां पे देखो जरा ध्यान से, ये जो पोटेंशियल है इस पे अगर बिल्कुल परपेंडिकुलरली मूव करो तो तुम्हें क्या होगा कि हर कर्व पे परपेंडिकुलर रहना है, तो तुम्हें इस तरीके का कर्वेचर मिलता चला जाएगा. बिकॉज यू हैव टू बी परपेंडिकुलर. ये थोड़ा सा इसको बड़ा करके देखना होगा आपको, अगर आप ये समझना चाहते हो. कैन यू सी दैट? अब देखो.
यस सर.
इफ यू, मेरा कर्सर दिखाई दे रहा है?
यस सर.
यस.
अगर तुम परपेंडिकुलर रहना चाहो तो देखो, तुम्हें ऐसे करके मूव करते हुए ऐसे निकलना पड़ेगा. ओके, दिस इज द इक्विपोटेंशियल सर्फेस ऑफ दिस. तो एक बार तो जरूरी होता है कि कम से कम आप एक बार इस चीज को देखो और रियलाइज करो कि वॉट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ दिस. तो पोटेंशियल ले लिया और पोटेंशियल को कॉन्स्टेंट कर करके उससे लोकस बना लिया, एंड दीज सर्फेसिस आर नोन एज इक्विपोटेंशियल सर्फेस. एनी डाउट एनीबडी वॉन्ट्स टू आस्क? तो ये दोनों एक ही हैं, एक ही सेट के दोनों कर्वेचर हैं. ये दोनों एक ही सेट के कर्वेचर हैं, राइट?
यस सर.
तो अगर आप यहाँ पे इसको बनाओगे तो कैसा होगा? ये वाला स्ट्रेट लाइन वाला 0 1, ये है, ये क्या हो जाएगा? -1 -2, राइट? और ऐसे इस साइड पे ये है जीरो, ये है वन, ये है टू, और इसका वाला इधर बना हुआ है माइनस वन एंड माइनस. सो यू कैन सी द डायरेक्शन इन विच आई एम मूविंग. सो माइनस वन से माइनस टू के डायरेक्शन में पोटेंशियल क्या हो रहा है?
घट रहा है सर.
घट रहा है, इसीलिए देखो फील्ड उसी डायरेक्शन में है. तो बना सकते हो ना सब लोग, कॉपी पे अच्छे से बनाना और पोस्ट करना ग्रुप में. ओके
यस सर,
प्रॉपरली. इज दैट ओके एवरीबॉडी?
यस सर.
सो नाउ द फॉर्मुलेशन पार्ट इज कंप्लीट एंड नाउ वी विल after this class, after doing few more problems of potential field, this and that, बहुत अच्छी अच्छी problems हैं इसके ऊपर, so we will do that and then we will enter into the cylindrical coordinates and spherical polar coordinate and then we will open up to distribution of charges. So point charge के लिए सब कुछ सीख लिया and बस अब उसी formulation को हमें replicate कर देना है and this way we will move. So are you comfortable everybody?
Yes sir.
Okay then, so we will stop here and we'll continue tomorrow. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.